Penguin Random House Audio presents The Anxiety Sisters Survival Guide, How You Can Become More Hopeful, Connected, and Happy. Written and read by Abbe Greenberg and Maggie Sarachek. This is the author, Abbe Greenberg. We dedicate this book to the Anxiety Sisterhood. Thank you for making us part of your lives, for sharing your stories, and for taking care of each other. We could not have written this book without you. If you surrender to the wind, you can ride it. Toni Morrison. There is something inside of you that is greater than any obstacle. Christian D. Larson. Introduction. You've come to the right place. Sit down, grab a coffee, decaf if you're anxious. Hang out with us for a while. We know what you're feeling because we've felt it too. We too have spent hours and hours looking through book titles, surfing the internet, combing through magazines, hoping to find answers or clues. We too have spent a small fortune, okay, not that small, seeing doctors, acupuncturists, therapists, hypnotists, nutritionists, and just about any other ist. We've looked for something to grab onto, even though we weren't sure what it was we needed or where we could find it. We just knew we felt lousy and wanted to feel better. Malcolm Gladwell, author of Outliers and more recently Talking to Strangers, wrote that to be an expert, one must practice for at least 10,000 hours. We've tripled that. We've practiced 20,000 hours, the equivalent of 20 years, suffering from anxiety and another 10,000 learning how to manage it. We've not only walked the walk, but we've huddled, heaved, hurled, sweated, palpitated, and hyperventilated our way through our life journeys. On planes, on trains, in cars, at weddings, at funerals, in grocery stores, on playgrounds, at work, at home, and at family gatherings. Been there, done that, got the t-shirt. We've spent at least a full year of our lives Googling symptoms of diseases we didn't actually have, and some that don't actually exist. If there were a PhD in obsessive thinking, we'd both have one. And if there is a more adept catastrophizer than us, we have yet to meet her. There was no molehill too tiny for our mountain-building skills. Put it this way, no paper cut went unwatched for signs of flesh-eating bacteria. Kidding aside, anxiety is a very real illness, and we really suffered for a long time. So how did we start to feel better? Recovery is messy, and healing is not linear, so there aren't four easy steps we can lay out for you. And don't trust anyone who claims he or she has such a plan. We approach anxiety not as a problem to be solved or a tumor to be excised, but rather as a part of who we are as human beings. Therefore, our goal is to live happily with our anxiety. This can only happen, however, if anxiety doesn't rule the roost. We began feeling better when we regained control over our own decisions and choices. This book is all about keeping you in charge, and every strategy and technique we present serves that function. One of the hardest parts of having an anxiety disorder is the loneliness and sense of isolation that accompany it. The reality is that we couldn't be less alone. In fact, according to the National Institute of Mental Health, 31.1% of adults in the United States will experience an anxiety disorder at some point in their lives. And here's the kicker, women are twice as likely to suffer from these disorders as men. We may be members of the world's largest sorority with the toughest initiation. When your world is upside down, it helps to know that others understand what you are going through, especially because mental health issues are still so stigmatized in many places. So many of us deal with blame and shame, the antidote for which is realizing that you are not alone in your struggles. As such, we believe an important part of the healing process is connecting with others experiencing similar challenges. In fact, we know that connection is a crucial component of happiness. Recognizing this, we've spent the better part of the past decade interviewing, coaching, and doing workshops for thousands of anxiety sufferers. In addition, we created an online community of more than 200,000 folks at the time of writing, from 200-plus countries and territories around the world. In our professional lives, as educators, researchers, counselors, and podcasters, we have had the opportunity to speak with countless other mental health experts as well. The result of all these interactions is a treasure chest filled with stories of the anxiety experience, as well as real-world anxiety management techniques, both of which we will share with you in this audiobook. It is our hope that you will hear some of your own story in the stories we present, and that you will feel comforted knowing you are not alone. You will hear what has helped, what hasn't helped, and what we wish we knew at the beginning of our struggles. Because anxiety is an invisible illness, people don't treat it with the same gravitas as other physical disorders. If you break your leg, your cast guarantees that no one will expect you to climb a flight of stairs. In fact, people will offer to carry your things and help you to the elevator. No such luck for anxiety sisters. The help you will most likely be offered is the suggestion to simply relax or calm down. And we all know that in the entire history of calming down, no one has ever calmed down by being told to calm down. For this reason, we refer to anxiety as a brain illness rather than a mental illness. In fact, you'll find we like to rename lots of stuff. Anxiety disorder is not a personality trait or a moral failing. It is a malfunction of parts of the brain, which can be seen on an MRI scan. Anxiety is a real thing. It is a disorder, not a decision. When we started to learn about basic neuroscience, we understood that our disorders were just as physical as more visible ones, that having anxiety disorder was no more our fault than having a broken leg. This realization enabled us to stop blaming ourselves for our struggles. We weren't weak, lazy, unmotivated, or flaky. We had an illness. Shame is a huge energy suck. Constantly berating yourself and internalizing external criticism only exacerbates anxiety symptoms and makes you feel exhausted and, even worse, powerless all the time. Placing the blame where it belongs, on your brain, frees up energy so you can focus on healing. So, and don't get anxious, we are going to teach you some very basic neuroscience in this audiobook. We promise it will be very easy to understand, and we want you to stop blaming yourself for your disorder. Once we understood that we weren't alone or at fault in our struggles, we started to feel some relief. But we didn't learn to live happily until we overhauled our thinking completely, because the way we had conceptualized anxiety and happiness was precisely what kept us anxious and unhappy. We know how this sounds, but trust us, this is the secret sauce. We are going to dive right into it in Chapter 1, so hang on one more minute. If you're wondering about strategies and techniques, including medication, there will be plenty for you in the upcoming chapters. Plenty of techniques, not medication. We use techniques every day, and we will teach you how to use them too. But the techniques are most helpful once you've dumped the blame and shame, understood the underlying science, and learned the recipe for the secret sauce. The Anxiety Sisters Survival Guide is meant to be a field guide to anxiety. Everything you've ever wanted to know about anxiety, but were too anxious to ask. Aside from anecdotes and strategies, you can also read about the current research in the mental health field, basic neuroscience, and our overarching philosophy of how to live happily with anxiety. We used to feel that we would never be able to fully enjoy our lives, but here's some good news. We don't feel that way anymore. We once felt overwhelmed, lonely, hopeless, frightened, ashamed, and at times more than a little crazy. Sound familiar? More good news. You too can feel connected, hopeful, normal, mostly, and able to cope. This audiobook will show you how. Author's notes. First, every story you hear in this audiobook is from a real person. We have done our best to use the actual words, editing only for clarity. To honor confidentiality, we have changed all names, although we have kept the true ages at the time of the interview. We are deeply grateful to all of these strong, generous women. Second, there are stories in this audiobook that reflect traumatic experiences, which may be triggering for some listeners. We included them because trauma is part of so many Anxiety Sisters' lives. To leave those stories out would invalidate their experiences. We believe it's important in the healing process to talk about the hard stuff. Feel free to skip over anything that makes you uncomfortable. One more note. You will hear us using the term Anxiety Sisters throughout this audiobook. For us, Anxiety Sisters include anyone of any gender who suffers from anxiety on any level.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.